I'll greet the feast to you, the Earl of Aberdeen. Sir, accept the assurance of my hearty thanks and cordial admiration. Phonograph of Paris, Roland Salem. Yours faithfully, Aberdeen. I will now introduce to you the Earl of Meath. Sir, this evening will be ever cherished by me as one of the most interesting of my life. I have to thank Mr. Knowles for introducing me to you. Using is one which makes permanent the voices of those who are speaking to you. I trust that the friendship between the English speaking races may ever be as permanent as we understand will be the voices which are uttered this evening. Yours very sincerely, please. I now beg to introduce to you Lord Roughton. In the voice of Lord Roughton, you have the immortal shade of Lord Vigenfield. Dear sir, the words of Colonel Gouraud make me deeply regret that he whose honored name he is mentioned is not here tonight to share with Mr. Gladstone the astonishment and admiration which your grand work has excited in all our minds. I am yours very faithfully, Ruth.
I now will introduce to you Sir John Fowler. Whose amazing work on the fourth bridge is the only rival presenting itself to my mind of your own marvelous invention.
On behalf of the civil engineers of England, Sir John Fowler sends hearty congratulations to Mr. Edison on his wonderful invention.
I now introduce to you, dear Mr. Edison, Sir William Hunter, the author of the Great Statistical Survey of India.
Dear Mr. Edison, on behalf of the Indian Administrator of the British Crown, I send you our sincere congratulations on having perfected one of the great wonders of our age. In India, we see many marvels. But during a quarter of a century, I have never seen either in India or Europe so great a marvel as we have seen and heard tonight.
Thank you.
has been to conclude this photograph with 3 jars for Edison.
Off of the car.